Welcome. In this tutorial, we will discuss decision making with probabilities. Some refer to this as decision making under risk. We will be covering the expected value or expected monetary value and the expected value of perfect information. We will be using this payoff table where payoffs are profits and the probabilities of the states of nature are 0.2, 0.5, and 0.3 respectively. The expected monetary value. This is a weighted average of the payoffs for a decision alternative. The weights are the probabilities of the different states of nature. For bonds, the expected value is calculated as 0.2 times 40 plus 0.5 times 45 plus 0.3 times 5, which equals 32. For stocks, the expected value is 0.2 times 70 plus 0.5 times 30 plus 0.3 times negative 13, which equals 25.1. For mutual funds, the expected value is 0.2 times 53 plus 0.5 times 45 plus 0.3 times negative 5, which equals 31.6. The best expected value is 32. Therefore, the decision is to invest in bonds. Expected value of perfect information. The expected value of perfect information, EVPI, is the maximum amount you will be willing to pay for additional information about a decision problem. That is, if we have perfect information about the state of nature before the decision is made, how much is this information worth? The formula for the expected value of perfect information is EVPI equals EV with PI minus EV without PI. EV with PI is the expected payoff if perfect information about the states of nature is known. EV without PI is the expected value without perfect information, which is the best expected payoff without additional information. That is the maximum EMV. The maximum EMV was determined to be 32 earlier. To calculate EV with PI, expected value with perfect information, we choose the best payoff for each state of nature and multiply them by the probability of their state of nature and add the results. So EV with PI is 70 times 0.2 plus 45 times 0.5 plus 5 times 0.3, which equals 38. The expected value with perfect information is 38. As calculated earlier, the expected value without perfect information or maximum EMV is 32. Therefore, EVPI is 38 minus 32, which is 6. So if we have perfect information about the states of nature before the decision is made, the expected value of that perfect information will be 6. And that's how you calculate EVPI. Thanks for watching.